The Burlington City Council on today, February 21st, 2017. I'd like to take a moment to ask everyone to please silence all cell phones and electronic devices. It's my honor to deliver tonight's invocation. Let's take a moment. We are thankful for this day that has been given to us, for its opportunities and its challenges. We ask for strength, insight, wisdom, and guidance as we forge ahead, keeping in mind always the enduring values of life, exerting our efforts on those areas and on those things upon which future generations can build with confidence. Amen. We have a special presentation tonight. I'd like to call on Mr. Scott Farmer, Executive Director of the NC Housing Finance Agency. Welcome.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. My pleasure to be here today. My name is Scott Farmer. I'm the Executive Director of the North Carolina Housing Finance Agency. I'm proud to represent our Board of Directors and our staff here tonight. I'd like to recognize a couple of folks with me from our staff. Will Perry Hill, Mike Hanley, and Troy Hirschberger in the back of the room with us. Our agency is a self-supporting agency with a plain, simple mission of financing affordable housing across the state. We finance everything from solutions to homelessness to home buyer mortgages. Today, we celebrate the power of partnerships and the importance of home. Over 100 families in Alamance County have improved housing thanks to a long-standing partnership between the Housing Finance Agency and the City of Burlington. This partnership has improved the health outcomes, help seniors age in place, and strengthen the community. Thank you to the mayor, honorable members of the council, Manager Watkins, and city staff that has made this partnership so successful. For the past 25 years, the North Carolina Housing Finance Agency and Burlington have worked together to rehabilitate the homes of some of Alamance County's most vulnerable citizens. We've invested over $1 million in repairs and accessibility modifications for seniors, veterans, and folks with disabilities. We also celebrate a long-standing partnership with the City and the North Carolina Home Builders Association in our construction training partnership. The City, the Home Builders Association, and our agency partner to teach at-risk individuals construction skills. I am pleased to report that the program has graduated over 300 men and women from the construction training partnership. I would like to recognize Kep Taylor from the Home Builders Association. Kep's energy and dedication is what made this construction training partnership a major success. I'd also like to thank the Alamance County delegation, Senator Rick Dunn, Representative Steve Ross, and especially Representative Dennis Rydell. Representative Rydell chairs the Appropriations Committee that makes housing investments like the Housing Trust Fund possible. The Trust Fund makes this partnership work, and none of our other work would be possible without the support of your delegation. These investments in home rehabilitation yield tremendous savings. With a very modest amount of money, modifications and emergency repairs can keep very low-income seniors or people with disabilities in their homes where they want to be and out of expensive institutional settings. The General Assembly created the Housing Finance Agency as a public corporation in 1974. Since then, our work has directly impacted the lives of over 255,000 North Carolina families, 3,500 of whom are in Alamance County. Thank you for your partnership. It makes a tremendous difference in communities like Burlington and in the lives of veterans, working families, seniors, and people with disabilities. We look forward to continuing our partnership for another 25 years. This time I'd like to read the plaque that we would like to present to the City of Burlington. In recognition of the 25-year partnership between the City of Burlington and the North Carolina Housing Finance Agency, and the investment of more than $1 million that has helped more than 100 families with housing rehabilitation, and over 300 students trained with construction skills in the Construction Training Partnership with the North Carolina Home Builders Association. Thank you for your stewardship, professionalism, and dedication to those in need of our community. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
If we would like to invite you down for a photograph, and thank you again for all of your support over the years.
Yeah. Council, if we could step down from the bench for a moment. Interact yourself to the evening.
Go. It's got a booster seat. Go ahead.
I'm going to say it. mama. Just have everybody turn just like that. Perfect. Perfect. And then we just got a lot closer together. Thank you so much.
At this time, we recognize our city clerk.
Members of council, it's my responsibility to remind you of your duty to avoid conflicts of interest in matters that are before us. This time, I ask if there are any potential conflicts concerning tonight's agenda items.
Before council, our minutes from February 6th and February 7th meetings. Do I hear a motion to approve the minutes as before you?
So moved.
Second.
All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
All those opposed? Minutes have been approved. The agenda has been set forth. Do I hear a motion regarding the agenda?
Move the adoption of the agenda.
Well, a consent agenda, I've got an item, but otherwise, motion to approve the agenda.
Would you like to amend the?
I would ask that item A, the first one about the parking on Lexington Avenue, be removed from the agenda at this time. And I'm going to talk to staff and city manager, and probably the first meeting in April, I'll maybe be ready to put it back on. If the pleasure of the council would be to take it off, I would appreciate it.
Second.
Kathy, any objections to
amend my
motion? Okay. All right. All those in favor of the amended motion, please say aye.
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 All those opposed? Agenda has been approved. Your consent agenda items, these are typically non-controversial if anyone has any questions. Item B, to appoint Jimmy Stevens to the local firefighters relief fund board at the Burlington Fire Department until he resigns or a new representative is appointed by the city council pursuant to North Carolina General Statute 588430. Item A to adopt the ordinance approving the following traffic commission recommendations. We've removed the first bullet point, so the second bullet point is to reduce the speed limit on Maple Avenue between Avon Avenue and Anthony Street from 45 miles an hour to 35 miles an hour. Item C, to approve a carnival permit for the Powers Great and American Midways to operate April 13th, 2017 through April 22nd, 2017 from 5 p.m. until 11 p.m. weekdays and from 1 p.m. until 11 p.m. on Saturday and Sunday. The carnival will be held at Holly Hill Mall parking lot located at the southwest corner of International Drive and Ann Elizabeth Drive, contingent upon meeting insurance requirements. Item D, budget amendment 2017-37, Recreation, Conference Carolina's Spring Sports Festival, details of which are spelled out in your agenda. Do I hear a motion to approve the following consent agenda?
We'll approve the consent agenda.
Second.
All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
All those opposed? Consent agenda has been approved. We have a public hearing this evening. Item one, a public hearing has been set for citizens to comment on potential area housing and neighborhood improvement activities to be addressed in program year 2017 of the annual action plan of the community development program. At this time, council recognizes Sonia Rudolph. Welcome.
Good evening, Mayor and Council members. I'm Sonia Randolph. I am the new Community Development Administrator. I did come to the previous meeting also on February 7th, but just wanted to introduce myself again. So at the February 7th Council meeting, we set a date for public hearing to receive citizen comments on area housing and community development for the CDBG and home programs to address in the program year 17 action plan for 2017 through 2018. Staff plans to use the citizen comments received at this public hearing tonight to develop the public program year 17 action plan. The program year 17 action plan describes the proposed sources and activities for CDBG and home funds. In the fall, staff sent out a request for proposal to local nonprofits. We did receive four funding requests. One came from Ralph Scott Life Services, and they requested $52,000 of funding for renovations to its facilities. We also received another one from the Burlington Development Corporation for $36,000 in matching funds for their Hope and Steps housing programs. We also received a request from the Alamance County Library, and they requested continued funding of the North Park Library for $10,000. And we also received a request from the Alamance County Community Services Agency for the required 15% set aside for CHODOs, or Community Housing Development Organizations, using home funds to develop the Apple Tree Village. As of right now, we actually have not received our CDBG and home funding allocations. HUD has not released that information yet. Last year, though, we did receive a little over $402,000 for CDBG. Last year, we received $402,011 in CDBG funding. For home, we actually have, we're actually a part of a consortium with the city of Greensboro. So for the city portion of the home program, we received $134,646. And then we also managed the county's allocation for the home portion of $73,758. And I do think that we do have some organizations here tonight that we'd like to see. Do you all have any questions for me at the moment?
Any questions from council?
So we have the Alamance County Community Services Agency here.
Good evening. I'm Annette Orbert, and I've been the executive director for 6 months, and I'm hoping there'll keep me another six or more at Alamance County Community Services Agency. Nicole Blackwell Outlaw has been working with our housing program, and she will give you more information.
Good evening. I'm Nicole, and I am the Housing Development Coordinator for the Apple Tree Subdivision. We are looking to complete the remaining four lots in Apple Tree. This program has been our second subdivision. The first one was completed in Westmoreland, where we completed eight houses. And then the Apple Tree Subdivision is a total of 18. We partnered with Habitat to complete six lots, and we are looking to complete four more. And this helps us to afford the health of the families, be able to afford the opportunity to be a homeowner. So I chose money to be used for that purpose.
Thank you. And welcome.
Thank you. Do we have any other organizations here tonight that would like to speak?
Good evening. My name is Robin Winkringham. It's my privilege to serve as the Executive Director at Habitat for Humanity. It's nice to be here tonight. I just want to thank you all for supporting the work of Habitat through both CDBG funding and also through home funding. We're also a CHODO, and you all have graciously allowed us to participate in Apple Tree Village as part of the three-way partnership, and we appreciate that. Last year, you also allocated us a portion of money for our Richmond Hill development. Just as an update to you all, Cone Health has committed to have a primary care facility there in a much underserved neighborhood, and we're thrilled about that. Head Start has also made a commitment to the Burlington Police Department, and we're hoping that a fitness facility will join us as well. So thank you for that, and thank you for providing that funding to spur on development.
Thank you.
MJ Wilkerson, I'm the Director of Alamance County Public Libraries, and I would like to say how much I appreciate how you all have supported North Park Library through the CDBG in the past. I'm really happy to share some figures with you from November. We've made a staff change there and some other changes, and we have had our circulation from November compared to last November went from 419 January of 2016, 419 circulations to 733 this month for January of 2017. And the number of visitors through the door has gone from 380 in January of 2016 to 448. But the real impressive number is the number of reference questions that we've answered, 57 last January 2016 to 287 this January. So we're real pleased to see that we're starting to see some of our efforts come to fruition, and we hope to have continued partnership there and make that even better.
Excellent. Thank you.
We also have Kat here too, that runs the construction training program with our partnership that we do with the North Carolina House and Finance Agency.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor, and members of the council. I hope this isn't redundant. Thank you for your support in the past. We'd love to continue here in the construction training partnership. We help folks get training of limited means and also try to impact affordable housing. And really appreciate you all and look forward to working with the staff or meeting Sonia, which is brand new.
Thank you.
I'd like to point out we just met just a few seconds ago. So I did also want to make you aware that in our projected budget, since we have not received the actual allocation amounts from HUD, we did project based on last year's allocation that we have allocated also $100,000, or tried to budget $100,000 for the North Park development. We also, I'm still in talks with our HUD rep to make sure that some of the infrastructure projects that are coming before me, there are two, a sidewalk project and then possibly the stormwater project. I'm actually talking to our HUD rep just to make sure that those projects are actually both, and not the sidewalk project, but the stormwater one is one that is an eligible activity under CDBG. Do you all have any more questions or any questions or anything from me?
So this is a public hearing, so if anyone on this side of the room would like to speak. Anyone else on this side of the room would like to speak? Yes, please. Welcome.
First of all, my name is Doreen Cole. I'm with Rise Spot Life Services, and I am operations director there. First of all, I'd like to thank you for the money that we got last year for the Black Grant. It helped to enhance the day program for our individuals. And just a little bit about what we do. We are a private, nonprofit social services organization founded in 1971, whose purpose is to provide residential and day services to 140 adults with intellectual and other disabilities. RSL has served Ellis and Caswell counties for 44 years. Our proposal this time is to renovate the interior of the day facility, which is 1212 Tarantine Street. We acquired the property from Alamance County, and last year we did some much renovations needed, but we also have more that need to be done. The building has been in use for almost 40 years as a day service or workshop program for adult citizens of Alamance County and Burlington who have intellectual and other disabilities. Currently, the day program serves 87 individuals. Approximately 76 of those individuals also are served in residential programs operated by RSL, and another 11 come from the community where they reside with their families. It's the largest and oldest program of this type available to the citizens within Alamance and Burlington area. At this time, RSL needs to renovate the bathrooms in the building, which have not been updated since 1971. This will include both men's and women's bathrooms, plus two multi-style bathrooms and a unisex changing bathroom for the individuals that we support. We're requesting funding from the CDBG program to renovate the bathrooms to provide a safer and healthier environment for the people who attend the program there on a daily basis. renovations funded by the grant will include removing of ceiling tiles, painting, replacing all fixtures, partitions, mirrors, and lights. Ralph Scott Life Services will be responsible for the stripping, waxing and flooring, floor replacement where needed, and painted offices and other areas of the building not included in the previous interior renovations. So, yes, we're asking for the money to do that. And thank you for your time.
Thank you. Is there anyone else on this side of the room? Do I hear a motion to close public hearing?
So moved.
All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
All those opposed? Thank you very much, everyone. Item two, for our new business, City Council will receive information on the downtown wayfinding plan and consider approving budget amendment 2017-38, Burlington Downtown Corporation wayfinding amendment to allow for the installation of wayfinding signs. Details of which are spelled out in your agenda. At this time, Council recognizes Nolan Kirkman, Director of Development and Technical Services.
Thank you, Mayor. Council, you may recall in the 2015 state budget there was $96,107 that was allocated to the City of Burlington for downtown revitalization efforts. And so staff worked with the downtown corporation and we brought a recommendation to Council in March of last year to use those funds on wayfinding. Wayfinding in the downtown area was something that was in the downtown master plan as well. So since that time, after council approved that, as the project BDC, Downtown Corporation has been working with their design firm, Dizelle Design Incorporated, and they've been also working with city staff to put together a design. And so tonight we have with us Jan Davis, who's the Downtown Corporation Board President, and Jessica Passion, who is the Executive Director. Certainly could help me with any questions you may have. I've put on the screen here the general plan or graphics layout for the wayfinding signs. The first one on the left is a larger sign that would be located on the, there's nine signs like this that would be located on the outside of the Municipal Service District directing motors to the downtown area or attractions in the downtown area. The second sign shown here is representing 19 signs that will be located inside the Municipal Service District and of course, you know, showing directing folks to different things within the downtown area. And then the last sign is a parking sign that was designed to help guide folks to free parking areas in our blocks. I thought I'd throw this one up as well because this gives you a little better sense for the scale of the signs. So you can see these type of signs would be up on you know, highways like US 70 or coming off of exits. And then of course this one would be the ones that we would see downtown. And we would just place the parking signs on some of the on existing poles. So that is the general idea behind the design. And what we need tonight as approval is a budget amendment that was in your packet, and that allocates the needed funds and expenditure accounts to be able to move forward with the implementation of the plan. We do have a deadline of the end of June to get this done, so we're hoping to meet that deadline. We'll be moving very quickly. Any questions you might have?
Are those poles just facsimiles, that, or is that what it's going to look like?
This is what it's going to look like. These are black aluminum poles. Obviously, our poles downtown are not black, they're light gray. But this would be a black aluminum pole, and this would be a larger, but yeah, black aluminum pole as well.
Other questions from council?
Yeah, but these on the gateway entrances that we were talking about, as far as out to the interstate, or how far out are you going to put them?
Okay, so. Well, I can show you a graphic might help if you need to see that. Yeah. So right here you see the yellow pinpoints. That shows you where the ones on the exterior parts of the city are going to be located. A couple of those are interchanges that kind of get you more directly into downtown. Some other ones are off of exits where you would be approaching US 70 as a main corridor to get you to downtown. And then as you go into the downtown area, you see where the 19 are located. And then there's a couple more up here to catch traffic house on web. So we, the idea was to maximize what we could get done with the $96,000. And then I think when you see in the budget amendments, just a little bit of funds needed from the BDC's or fund balance to really make up the difference. But that was the general idea, and I think we've done about what we can on that.
Any other questions from council? Do I hear a motion to approve this expenditure item?
So moved.
Second.
All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye. Aye.
All those opposed? Motion is passed. Thank you. Moves us or wraps up our agenda
Somebody
items.
Somebody had a question.
Yes, sir.
I was under the impression I had a sign-up list to speak at tonight's meeting, and I don't know if I'm going to be called later or...
Yeah, that's or later in the meeting. So, thank you. Next item on our agenda is city manager comments.
Thanks, Mr. Mayor. A couple items related to March 7th. So council has scheduled a goal-setting work session for March 7th to review some programs and things looking forward for the next year. Just to confirm with council, we're going to schedule that for 8:30 a.m. For a start time to 5 p.m., and we'll be doing that at the Lake McIntosh Clubhouse. So you'll get more details on those logistics as time moves along. As we have studied that date and trying to be sensitive to council members' time, staff has determined that there may not be a need for a March 7th city council meeting. If council is so inclined to cancel that, this would be a good time to do that this evening. Chatted with Renee Ward and Beverly Smith, and we're not aware of any pressing agenda items that cannot be delayed until the second meeting in March. So if council's so inclined, this would be a good time to.
Are there any objections to canceling the March 7th council meeting?
Well, it'd be difficult to do, but I'll go along with it.
The work session. There would still be a work session the day before.
Correct.
Yeah, but this is casual.
Twist his arm.
Do I hear a motion to cancel?
So moved.
Second.
All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
All those opposed? You don't want to spend the entire day there?
Yeah, I think if we have to cap with that, okay.
That's all I have, Mr. Mayor.
Thank you, manager. Now we have our public comment period. Mr. Is it Caminti?
Yes.
Thank you for your time. Me is about the zoning that's supposed to be put into place on Barnett Bridge Parkway, opposite the firehouse and the school, and against this proposal zoning of 120 apartments for the following reasons. The increased increased traffic on Barnett Bridge Parkway between, it's become like a thoroughfare there now, between the traffic, trucks, vehicles, and others, and with this proposed housing development, there are apartments. You're going to have at least another 100 cars that are going to be involved in traffic on Barnett Bridge Parkway and on Danbrook. And I think that should be reconsidered. And also, having 120 units would be an increase on the service for the city of Burlington, and also increase in water and power. And if I recall, we've been here in Burlington for at least the past 10 years. We had a severe drought several years ago. And with the increase in the population here in the city of Burlington, I don't know if we have enough water to satisfy the demands of the citizens of the city of Burlington. So we should keep that in mind. And also, there's also, which I think we should keep in mind, is the loss of our woodlands and green belts and waterways. That if you hope you would take that into consideration when somebody proposes a development or a shopping mall or a strip mall. I think it will be better for this location if they want to put these 120 apartment units to have housing, private homes for 50 and over of age, in which we may be able to take up about 30, 40 homes could be built there, which would result in less stress on the system and services that would be required by the city of Burlington. I think that should keep that in mind. And there's a demand for housing for people over the age of 50. I think that would be a good thing for this city council to consider. In closing, I would like to say the board of, I hope, would have plans for controlled development for Burlington, for the Goodwood citizens, and to preserve, protect the lands, the woodland, the green belts, lakes, waterways for the betterment of the community and its environment. We don't do, the developers will take over time, take it away, and take up whatever's land they can use for their development. And we will lose the essence and the beauty of Burlington, and its environment will be lost forever. And I'd like to add some personal experience, because as you know, I'm not a native here, it's in North Carolina. I came from Long Island, New York, Nassau County, which I was born in Brooklyn, but my family raised up in Nassau County. And as it developed there, it was really amazing. Shopping malls, shopping centers, strip malls, housing developments. Back when I grew up, there was a lake near us. There was a short bike right away in which we could go fishing and swimming. Well, they drained that lake and put a housing development. And then near us, we had the wetlands, which had a certain amount of wildlife there. Well, they fill in the wetlands and another housing development. And if you don't think it couldn't happen here, think again, because it did happen where I live. It didn't happen overnight. So housing developed here, shopping mall over here, a little strip mall there. This is what we need. We need the business, and I understand that. You need good business to come here. But there's also a downfall to that. In Bedpage in Nassau County, they had Grumman's built great airplanes for the Navy. 25,000 employees there, with good jobs, high paying, great benefits, retirement plans. Well, they went out of business, and what it did to the community was a disaster. People had so many jobs that were connected, spin-offs from Grumman's, lost everything. That was a depressed area. Now, when I talked to some of the old-timers that lived in East Burlington, the General Westinghouse was there. When that plant closed, East Burlington never really recovered from that, from what I was told. And I believe it. So I think this supposedly 120 apartment units should be reconsidered and think about putting these homes for over 50 for the consideration. Be less stressful for the community. And you have to remember, McIntosh is basically a residential community. And you can change the complexion of the McIntosh by putting these apartments. I think it's one for you to be considered. Thank you for your time.
Thank you, sir.
And I have a request from the mayor himself. As you know, I don't know if you remember, the Citizens Academy. And we all got this little coin. We showed a coin. And the other person didn't have the coin, man. You owe me a beer.
I owe you a beer now. Thank you, sir. You got me.
One more thing, I just have to mention Mr. Huffman. We had many meetings at the courthouse, and there were some things that we said that the city had made mistakes on McIntosh. And I think if we put these apartments in, it would be a mistake also. If he wants to speak to me later, I'll tell him what the mistakes were. It doesn't matter. Okay, thank you.
Thank you, sir. All right, that concludes our public comment. Are there any council comments?
I've got one.
Yes.
I hope this is the last time I have to say this to the general public. I am really sick and tired of the violence that's happening in this town. People shooting in houses, murders. I'm really tired of it. The police is doing all they can to help stop this. But if you see something, say something, because this has to stop. We can't have our young men dying like they're dying out here and people shooting in houses. Some young kid may get shot. But again, I hope this is the last time, and I hope the public heeds this, and those criminal activities that are happening out in our city got to go away. And whatever it takes our police department to do, I'm sure they're going to do it. And just as soon as they can, and apprehend these people that are doing these crimes, put them under the jail. You can take that to the bank and say, I did say, take them, put them under the jail. That's where they need to be. But it has to stop. It really breaks my heart to see my city with this much criminal activity happening in it. I've never seen anything like it. People are coming in here and starting these gangs or whatever and drugs, and it breaks my heart to see that. It really does. And the sooner we can make this thing go away, the better our city is going to be. So I ask the citizens again, if you see something, say something. Call the police department. Call Crime Stoppers. Get this thing eradicated. We can't continue to do this to our people and citizens in this city. Thank you, Mayor.
Thank you. Any other council comments?
Mr. Mayor.
Yes.
I would request that the city council go into a closed session to discuss a personnel matter pursuant to NCGS 143-318-11A6 and to go into closed session pursuant to 143-18-11A5 for the purpose of discussing material terms of proposed contract for the acquisition of real property located at 138 East Front Street. Moorfield Floors, currently owned by Charles D. Thompson, and the city's purpose for acquiring is expanding the Paramount Theater.
We're going to close session.
Second. All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
All those opposed? Council will go into closed session. We'll return.
I'd just like to say, Mr. Fawcett, and any support or any assistance he needs from me, I'd be glad to help him in that matter.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
100%.
Thank you.
Council will return once we're done. Yep.
Yeah, we didn't have four. We just...
You saw we got a foosball table in there, right?
Really?
Yeah. It makes closed session so much more fun.
Did you go to the Elon thing?
No, it was in that room.
Oh, yeah, that Elon panel was today.
I know. I was hoping we'd get out of here so I could go.
Five people showed up.
Really? On the tax revaluation? Wow.
Is that your motion to resume?
So moved.
Second.
All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
All those opposed? Motion to adjourn?
So moved.
All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
All those opposed? Council is adjourned.